Oh, hello, fellow Vehicle Sim fans. Welcome back to Korivak Vehicle Sims. I'm Marcus Korivak. Today, it's going to be part one of our new series, the Off-Road October, where we're playing Spintires. Alright, let's get started. So, first of all, we're going to throw on a spare wheel on the back here, and a truck on top. So both of this give us repair points, 60 points for the spare tire, 200 points for the trunk. The trunk also can carry 80 liters of extra fuel, which is enough to give us a full tank, but it doesn't start filled. You have to actually take it to a fuel station to do that. All right. Start the engine, take off the parking brake, put it in first gear, and yep. I'm going to start with diff lock on. That means that our tires on each side will spin at the same rate. So as one gets stuck in the mud, it doesn't spin more than the other. Splashes onto the side of the vehicles, and then it will gradually dry off as well. The nice thing about this little Jeep is that even with its four-wheel drive on, it only burns 3 to 4 liters of fuel at a time. So it just sips fuel. Compare and contrast with some of the vehicles we'll have later on that substantially more fuel than that. Specifically a GAD 66, but not licensed, so it's just classified as a B. I have to say this is one of my favorite little trucks here, so let's see if it needs any. Yeah, it needs 151 points for repair, fully repaired. I can't refuel it because I don't actually have any fuel yet. I'm going to switch to our V66. Alright, it's got 65 liters of fuel. Alright. So, what we're going to do now. For a little bit. Gas 66 is basically what happens when you take a truck engine and a short truck frame and mount it up on giant four-wheel drive suspensions with pulleys on differential lock. Gear down a little bit. And then basically treat that truck like an overgrown Jeep. So it's got really, really good off-road capabilities and really good cargo capabilities for such a small vehicle. It's never going to be like a heavy hauler, but at least it carries more than the Jeep would. I'm pulling something with the parking brake on. That's fantastic. Parking brake off. Change truck. Let's see how much better we do now. Attach the winch. Switch the pole without. That's better. KVS 700 heavy duty tractor. Looks a little bit damaged. It's better. sorry, got 4 vehicles so far. A little Jeep that we left here. The K700 tractor. Big C4320 truck. And there's another 4320 over there. Let's head up. Grab that. And also top up our fuel as well. This thing just bouncing around over these tire ruts. It acts like the biggest Jeep ever. Nimble-footed goat of a truck. And for all it does, it still sips fuel. 5 liters at the most. A boat. Where's the boat? There we go. And out. Water just pouring out of us. C4320, same as the last one. So we have a pair of matched trucks. It's also fitted out for logs. Squelching sound effects. And our fuel is down to red because we're despite being a fairly fuel-efficient little truck of a vehicle here, we still do not have a huge amount to start with because this truck did not come fully loaded. Fix. God, that will suck the boots right off your feet. I think you can make it. And there we go. Safely arrived. Build up our internal tank, and then fill up these four barrels in the back, 100 liters of fuel each. Whew. Let's not go back that same way. Let's go around that way instead. As it could potentially be pretty boggy, but it could hardly be worse than that. Shortcut. Oh no, oh no! Well, maybe not. Alright, now it's time for the fun part of Spintires, where we get to do a rescue mission to save our sorry selves. Well, good news is we only did 3 units of damage out of 400. So, yeah. Didn't spill the fuel, and did not do too much damage, but we do need to come by and winch ourselves out. Well, I guess that's that for this particular trip. Oh well. Alright. We can fix this. We'll fix this next time.